Please enter your access code. To enable audio control, please enter your audio.
Hi. Hello?
Hi.
Hi. Hi, Kripti. This is Sam here. So I'm your trainer. So I see there are almost 8 members here. Okay.
Did you say after saying your shop, I didn't hear you, sorry.
Oh, you couldn't hear me?
Yeah, I know.
Okay. Did you guys dial in or are you all on the GoToMeeting audio?
I dial in.
GoToMeeting audio.
Yeah, so it's... Yeah. GoToMeeting audio is not at all clear. It will never be clear. Okay, this is through web, so there will be interferences and you'll have issues in hearing. So I would suggest if you can make a dial using your phone, that would be clear.
So, yeah, I connected to
my phone. So whenever you guys are using your phone call, then it would be clear. So there won't be any interfaces.
Like, yeah.
That would be better with phone call. Okay, I'll start sharing the screen. Can you guys see my screen?
Yeah, okay.
Okay. I guess most of them disconnected GoToMeeting call and they are going to dial in now. Let me wait till everyone. Already. Okay. Okay, there are a few more people who wanted to join. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay. You guys can go on mute. I'm just waiting for everyone to join the call so that I can start. Let's wait one more minute and then we'll start. Okay. So let's start. Maybe one guy dialed in and all of us are sitting behind him and beside him and listening to it. Okay. So what is NetSuite? NetSuite is a ERP and e-commerce application. It's cloud-based. It's also called as SaaS application, which is SaaS, which means software as a service. It's this SaaS, okay? SaaS application, that is software as a service. It's more, basically it's in cloud, and what do we do? What do companies do? What do clients do with NetSuite? They use it for their ERP and e-commerce. So ERP is enterprise resource planning. So it's the order to cash process or procure to pay. So these are the two main processes. I'll make a note of it. So the first process is order to cash. So any company or any client, they have their products, so they sell it to customers, and all the data is recorded in this order to cash process. So we have customers, customer records. Okay, these are NetSuite instance. In this, customer records are present in lists, relationships, and customers. So if you guys look into this, there is a list of customers that this particular client has, the Honeycomb client. They have all these customers. Okay, so order to cash process, we sell our products to customers. Where are the products? Lists, accounting, and we have items. So these items are being sold to the customers, and that process we record in NetSuite, and that is in order to cash process. So in order to cash process, there are many the different scenarios. Like few clients, they start with opportunity.
Hi, this is Chax
here. Hey Chax.
So I just wanted to check with you. Like, see, basically, I have 14 plus years of ERP experience.
Okay.
Now my only question is, I've never worked with NetSuite before.
Okay.
I would suggest if you can go slow and then start off and introducing and saying what exactly. So if it's an ERP, if you're talking about, this looks like it's a CRM, customer relationship management, and people talk about, talking about ERP, you have different wings of ERP, different entities of ERP. Now, I'm not really understanding what exactly is this NetSuite.
That's right. Okay.
Go slow.
Sure. The thing is, NetSuite, it's CRM plus ERP. Okay. So when I say NetSuite ERP, it has even CRM inside it. It has opportunity. It has the quote. It has sales order. From there on, it has invoice, the payments, everything. So if you compare to any CRM, for example, Salesforce is a CRM. Okay. You might know about CRM. You have experience of CRM, but all other guys, they don't have any experience of CRM. So if I get into more detail on CRM, they wouldn't understand. So that's why I'm just saying what all we have in NetSuite. So
yeah, I understand. Only question is basically which part of CRM is this NetSuite? Because basically, yeah, CRM is pretty big, right?
That's right. So in CRM, do you have your accounting? Do you have your journals? Do you have your payments? So that all process, okay. That all we have in NetSuite.
Different postings, or would you be starting off with the technical part?
I'm going to give admin first. Okay, that's what we're going to do first.
Okay,
we're going to go through the UI of NetSuite. Okay, what all we have in NetSuite. So when you guys go as a NetSuite consultant, so the first thing is you need to manage for your 8 hours. Okay, whenever I train you so that you'll be able to manage on site. So when they give you admin works, admin tasks, you should be able to manage them. So that's the first part of our training. Okay. So there are different tasks in administration. So I'll explain you guys on those admin tasks. Okay. So that you guys can manage. That's what we're going to cover first. Okay. Basic admin training. We're going to do that. And then we're going to touch up on our developing part, that is in detail. Not in detail. We'll do briefly, okay? Because we're gonna wrap up this training in like 15 classes. So in 15 classes, we can do an extensive admin training, and then we'll do a brief developer training. Is that okay, Chax?
Yeah, makes sense, Sam.
Yeah. So I'm gonna start admin training. So what kinds of admin tasks do you have? Like 90% of NetSuite clients. Can someone mute their go-to meeting or their call? I'm getting this sound of my voice. Okay.
Now you're good to go.
Yeah, okay. Thanks, Jax. So, in NetSuite, what are the admin tasks we have? So, 90 to 95% of clients, they use it for two processes. They are order to cash and procure to pay. And the other 5 to 10%, they use it for e-commerce. So what is e-commerce? E-commerce is, for example, we have a client called Sears. Okay, they have their website. So they host their website from NetSuite. And they put all the information on the website. when customers come in and buy it, make some transaction, then the data comes back into NetSuite. And that's where they start again, the sales order, invoicing, they pay, get the payments. So that is e-commerce part. And ERP is just the two processing ERP, that is order to cash and procure to pay. There are some other processes like inventory management and others, which we are not going to look into them. Mostly we are going to cover only these two processes, which is order to cash and procure to pay. Okay, since 80 to 85%, almost 90% clients, they use only these two processes for their ERP solution. Okay, so in these two processes, first I'm explaining you what are these processes. You might know Chax, but others they don't have any idea of this process. So that's why I'm explaining them. So they'll better know what order to cash is and what is procure to pay, and what happens.
I'm an administrator in PeopleSoft, so it's like I have a complete in and out experience on literally all the ERPs, entities of PeopleSoft, but not in NetSuite. Like if you talk about CRM, EPM, then it comes finance, HR.
Okay.
But I've never been on a development side. That's the reason why, if you're going through, I would definitely recommend if you go through little slower on the development part as well.
Yeah, development, we're not going to start right now.
We're going to
concentrate only on admin part right now. So mostly customizations, mostly CRM, right? You have the forms, you have the fields, you'll customize the form, the fields, layout. So that's what we're going to make sure, that's what we're going to go through. So that all these guys who are new to NetSuite, new to even IT industry.
No,
it's not migration part. Okay, migration that comes in. If you talk about migration, we have only one option called CSV import. That's the only thing that's in admin part. Okay, if we have CSV files, we can upload the customer data or we can upload sales orders. Yeah, that's the only thing in admin. Yeah, which we can import. Okay, that's the only thing. But setup, yeah, we have in admin, we have setup. We will do all kinds of setup. We'll enable the settings. We have a lot of settings. So I'll go through all those. Okay.
You set up in the sense the online setups, right? Not the actual physical installation part of your NetSuite.
No, that's not. There's nothing to install NetSuite. Okay. It's just online. You log into NetSuite. You have all these standards. Standard settings from NetSuite, like standard records. Okay, you have ordered all this from standard records. You do custom records. You create custom records. Okay.
Okay. Just a question before you start with, because basically, for me to understand, you say it's a web form.
Yeah.
Like let's say if you who's your employer right now?
Who's my employer?
Huh?
Okay, you can say Honeycomb.
Honeycomb. Okay.
Honeycomb. You can see over here.
Now, let's say if you're talking about Honeycomb, how exactly does Honeycomb? Do they have a online account with any of these SaaS providers where basically they buy a space and then afterwards you have the ERP installed on it, and then we customize it, and then we have different forms of environments like what do you call development and UAD, SAD, and then goes to your production. So do we have the same setup here?
Nothing. There's nothing. There's nothing like that. So every client, like Honeycomb or any company, they have a subscription with NetSuite. Okay, and they once they subscribe with NetSuite, they get this account. Okay, and they just use the account. This is small. NetSuite is very small. It's even if you compare to Salesforce or PeopleSoft, NetSuite doesn't have that much capability as much as Salesforce and PeopleSoft do. NetSuite is very limited. Okay, I'm going to explain that limited part. So you might know, once I walk through, you might know everything. Like you might feel, okay, this is the same that we do in Salesforce or PeopleSoft. But yeah, it is how it is. That's what NetSuite does. Okay. And it might not be new for you, but for others, all other guys who are listening now, this is something new to them. And you have 4 years of experience. And some of them, they may not even have any, even not even 1 month of experience, not even 1 day of experience, right? So Yeah, you have 14 years of experience, but someone has zero experience. Someone has not even, someone doesn't even have one day of experience. So if we continue our conversation like this, it's like they will be like, oh, what's going on? they are here to know something new. They don't know anything. So that's why let's see how it goes. You might get to know some new things in NetSuite, or you might feel it's equal to PeopleSoft or Salesforce. Then we'll see. Then we'll see from there how it goes on. Okay. Yeah. Okay. So to everyone, so what NetSuite does, NetSuite ERP. Okay. Within NetSuite ERP, every company, they have their items and they have a customer list. So they sell their items to the customers. Okay. That's the process for order to cash. So within order to cash, we have different forms. So we some clients, they start with opportunity, and then opportunity is followed by quote, and quote is followed by sales order, and sales order is followed by invoice. And from sales order, we do invoice and we also do shipment. So there are two things from sales order. I'll put one, item fulfillment. Okay, item fulfillment is shipping. So once we have sales order, so that means the customer is buying something from us. Then we send the items to him. That comes out of fulfillment. Okay. And then we invoice the customer to get payment. Even invoice is done from sales order. And then from invoice, we have this, you get cash from, you get payments, customer payments. So there's a process for, actually it's, so there's a process for order to cash. So it's not necessary that every client will use all this. Some clients may use just sales order. They may start from sales order to customer payments. When they start from sales order, you might ask, so they don't they use opportunity or quote? Certainly they will use, but they might be using some other application, for example Salesforce. So most of the clients, they use Salesforce for CRM, and then their sales order gets integrated into NetSuite, and they have some tools, like for example there's a tool called Boomi. So Boomi is a integration tool which integrates from Salesforce to NetSuite. So Boomi, most of the clients, they use Boomi for integrating their sales orders from Salesforce to NetSuite. So once the sales order comes into NetSuite, then they do the item fulfillment, invoicing, and then getting payments from customer. So this is order to cash. I can show you the process. So under transactions, under sales, you have this. You can see create opportunities, and from opportunities you create quotes, and from quote you create sales order, and from sales order you create invoices, and then you have the customer payments that come in. So on, for example, let's go to a opportunity. Transaction, sales, opportunities list. Let's see if there are any opportunities here. There are many. So let's open one opportunity. So from one opportunity, there should be, do we have related records? Yeah. So when an opportunity converts into a quote, on the opportunity you can see under related records, you'll have the quote. And all the related records, like that code converts into sales order, so you'll even have the sales order record here. So that's how the process is. From opportunity it goes to code to sales order, and sales order to then invoicing and item fulfillment. So I hope you guys have account, this Honeycomb account. If not, just let the guys who organize this session, they will get you an account so that you can practice. You can just go over this transaction, sales, and all this order to cash process is within this. So you can just try to create, practice them, just create them and see how can you convert it. There should be options, like on quote you might see a option create sales order. So you click the button, the quote gets converted into sales order. So it's like that. Just check this space. Okay, on this space you'll see the options where you can convert an opportunity to quote and quote to sales order, and it all depends on the status. So status should be approved. So we have that, even that's one criteria. So each and every instance, each and every record, like opportunity record or quote record or sales order record, some may need approvals, some may not need approvals. Okay, and look at the status. Status is opportunity identified. So after opportunity identified, what happens? Opportunity is in progress. So then this opportunity might get converted. You look options, okay, actions, you have new, make copy and show activity, that's it. So there is no option over here where you can convert this into code. Yeah, there is one. You can see over here, you see, click on code. So then this opportunity gets converted into a code. A code form should be opening up. And then if you have any changes on the code, changes which are not on the opportunity, you can make it on the code and then you save it. Then a code record is saved. See, you must enter. And you can have different items on opportunity and different items on code. So it's like that. So now it is not automatic conversion. We can even have automatic conversions, but that needs a custom process. Like you might have a script which takes an opportunity. If the status is approved, then create a code using all the data from opportunity and set it on the code. That's a custom process. But standard process is like this. On the opportunity, you selected the code and you have the code form open. Then you just need to manually enter all the information, like what all items you are selling to your customer, and then save it. So that's the process. So from opportunity, it's code to sales order, and then sales order to invoice and item fulfillment. So this is one process. Let's look at what is the other process. There's second process that is called procure to pay. So order to cash is whatever items we have. You didn't get it? What exactly opportunity? So you have your items, okay? okay, wait a second. Again, I'll go to an opportunity list. Sorry, I didn't get you. There's a problem. It's like I can't hear you clearly. Or else, can you type? I got a message from Kirti. Can you type so that I can hear? This is just Kirti.
Okay. Is it audible now?
There is a resound.
Is it audible now?
Yeah, I can hear you now.
Yeah, okay. No, it's a diagram actually of the sales order, better problem.
See, that's the problem. See, the thing is, you guys need to practice. I can't show each and every step. If we start getting into much detail, it's going to take more time. So actually, in the previous trainings, I never went into this much detail. So this is not actually admin. I'm just showing you the process, how NetSuite works, what is in NetSuite. So we need to start admin. What are the tasks in admin and how you can perform those tasks. So that's the main part of training. So that's why I said, if you have this account, just get into it, try to create an opportunity, see how an opportunity is created, look at the already created opportunity, you'll get an idea. Based on that, you can create your own opportunity and convert into code. So that you need to practice all that. And there, if you can't understand, then get back to me, then send me a direct email. I'll get one-on-one with you and then I can explain it to you clearly. So
is it open source? Like,
no, this is not open source. It's you mean when you create an opportunity, you feel someone else is seeing your opportunity? Is that your question? Kirti, you there?
Yeah, I'm here. I didn't get
it. No, can you explain your question once again? Yeah, you need to create your own account. You need to get an account.
Right?
Yeah, you need to get an account. So, do you have an account?
No,
Yeah, you should be given an account. That's what I said. If you don't have an account, whoever organized this training, just contact with them and ask for your NetSuite credentials. So, they'll create you an account and they'll provide you the ID password, and then you can log in and you can start practicing. You need that. Without practicing, I don't think anyone will get to know about NetSuite or learn NetSuite. Okay, so that's one process, which is order to cash. And then we have procure to pay. Order to cash is you're selling your items to your customer. That's what the client does, the company does. Okay, and procure to pay is the company buys from vendors, like buys from outside custom, like don't call it customers, it's called vendors. So customers are those who buy from us. Okay, vendors are those from whom we buy. Okay, for example, you have a company, you need some chairs or some laptops or some stationery. So you need to buy it from someone, like for example Dell or HP or Office Max or Staples or any client. So they are our vendors. We need to buy from them. So that all comes under procure to pay. Procure to pay process. Okay. Or it's even called purchasing in some companies, or you can even call procurement process. So they call it with different names. So procure to pay. So procure means you are asking, requesting them, hey, I want to buy this. They give you a rate and then you pay them and get it. So that all falls under procure to pay. So where is this procure to pay within NetSuite instance? So transactions, purchases. You have your purchase orders, you have requisitions, and this process starts with requisition. Okay, as order to cash starts with opportunity, procure to pay it starts with a requisition, and then it has purchase order. Then we have bills. Bills, nothing but we need to make payments to bills. Then payment. This is called vendor payment. And sometimes we may even have credits. We may return. You may buy something from a. It's like vendor credit. So you may order something from a vendor, but you make the payment, but you cancel it. So but you need to get credit back from the vendor. So we even have separate forms for vendor credits. It's same for even customer payments. You may have even a customer credit. So a customer ordered from us, we took payment from him, but then he cancels the order. So we have his payment. So we need to give the payment back to him. So that's done through customer credit. These payments, we get money in, and credits, we send it out. Over here, vendor payments, we are paying the money to vendor, and then vendor credit, we need to get the money back from vendors. Okay, I'll put over here slash and vendor credit. So for each one of this, we need to have a separate form in NetSuite. Like we have opportunity form, we have a quote form, we have a sales order form, we have fulfillment form, we have requisition form, we have purchase order forms. I'll do upgrade. And this process is here. Under purchases, you have requisitions, you have purchase order, and then we have the vendor bills. I don't see vendor bills in this, but yeah, maybe it's not selected for this account. So let's see our purchase order. Let's see the list. Where is it getting connected to? Okay, there's a closed purchase order. Let's see.
And just a quick question. Where do you get all this data from?
Which data? This data?
Any data for that matter. Would you do have to create these, right?
Yeah, it's not you creating it. Okay. So we as NetSuite consultant, we are not going to create an opportunity. We are not going to create a quote, or we are not going to create sales order. We are not creating purchase order. We are not creating any orders. Okay. We are not creating any of this. I just said to practice just to see how it works, how the process is. So for example, there's a company called Honeycomb. Okay. Honeycomb is using NetSuite. So they have their business, users. So they are the ones creating all this. As a NetSuite consultant, what is our job? So to customize NetSuite. So there's a purchase order. There's a person in business who creates purchase orders. Okay. He says, okay, I want this vendor field over here. I want this memo field under some tab, or I want some extra fields over here. I want to add extra information. That's when we come in. So we as NetSuite consultant, NetSuite developer, NetSuite admin, we create those, we customize it. Understand? So that's our job. We customize these forms. We don't enter the data.
Even an administrator does the same thing, is it?
That's right. Administrator, he does this customization, okay? And developer does the customization, and also he develops the script. He does the custom things using scripting and workflows. So that's what we do. That's why I don't want to get into detail of this. I don't want to get when, someone asked, right? Someone asked the flow. That's why I didn't want to get into detail, because it's not us who are creating this. In each client, each company, they have different flows. As I said, someone may not have opportunities. Someone may start from sales order and get into payments. And but procure to pay, even here, some companies may start from purchase order. They may not use requisition at all. And some clients, they may use everything, requisition, purchase orders, bills and payments. So that's each and every company, they have their own process. However they want, they follow it. And they are the ones creating it. And what we do is we just customize the forms to them. That's it. How they want NetSuite to look like. That's what we customize for them. Got it? So these are the two processes. Just go through it. Once you get your account, get into transactions tab, sales for the order to cash and purchases for procure to pay. Just look at what all forms are there, how are they connected. Look at the related records so that you can see what all connected. There should be this. If this purchase order is billed, there should be a bill over here, but it's not yet billed. So even before it gets billed, they have closed this. So each and every form, look at the status. Based upon the status, it may move further or it may get cancelled over there. So that these are the main processes used by each and every client. Okay. So now let's see what all we can do in admin. What all we do as a NetSuite administrator. So let's go through. Let's do a quick UI, like user interface walkthrough. What all do we have in all these tabs? Okay. So first thing, this is the recent records. What all you create? Like if you look at opportunity. See, we looked at opportunity. Before that, I looked at a workflow. Before that, I looked at a customer. So even if I create one, it appears over here. I created this customer. So it's like that. And then we have add to shortcuts. So if you want to create any shortcuts, you can create here, like purchase order, and then you can directly create that. Click on that and purchase order screen opens up. So that's adding shortcuts over here. Then we have the home screen. So whenever someone logs into NetSuite, the first thing they do is they click on home screen. Or the home screen is the one that by default it appears. Okay, whenever if I log out and log in, this is where it brings me on NetSuite, within NetSuite. On home screen, we have like some KPIs, which are key performance indicators, some portlets, and some information from NetSuite. Like NetSuite has release upgrades. They do upgrade every twice every year. So once they do it in March and once they do it in September. You may question me, what is upgrade? So on NetSuite, they introduce new features like twice every year. So even NetSuite is working hard to improve their application, to improve their capability, to add more features. So that's all. So when they implement a new feature, they provide us with the upgrade. So they have two upgrades. So right now we have an upgrade coming in 31 days, which is 16. They always name like this: 2016.1, 16.2, then next 2017.1, 17.2. That's how they name their releases. And here we have information about the next release. We have release notes. So if you click on release notes, you'll see what all new things NetSuite is adding into their application. Then they'll even provide a release preview login. So release preview is something different. We have sandbox, we have net production. So sandbox is where we implement all the new functionalities, we test it, and we move what all we implemented to production. So production is a live environment where our business is using and creating business, like creating all our transactions. And there's a third instance which is called release preview. NetSuite provides it only when there's upgrade coming up. So there's upgrade coming up, so they give this instance for like 3 to 4 weeks. We can log into that. That will be a replica of our production, and also with all the new features, new upgrades that NetSuite is going to add. So over there we do testing. So when you go and work in a company, whenever there's a release upgrade coming up, so they take out time for 3 to 4 weeks. They just keep testing everything. So whatever functionality is there in their NetSuite, will it work in the new upgrade, new release? So all the release functionalities, all the new functionalities will be present in this release preview instance, and also our production data will be there. There will be a replica of it. Then we as IT, NetSuite consultants, NetSuite developer, admin, we all are part of IT. Okay. First we test it, and then we give it for business. So business users, they test it. They perform some sample transactions, some dummy transactions they create, and they see each and every process if it's working or not. All the functionalities that they requested to us and we provided, is all that working or not? That's what they test. And if something doesn't work, they come back to us, hey, this is not working. So if we look at it, why it's not working, we fix it. If we don't know why it's not working, it's working in production sandbox, it's not working in this, we contact NetSuite support. Hey, did you take away something or from in the new release, or why is it not working? Did you cancel any functionality, or is there a bug, or is it an enhancement? Then NetSuite support, they work on it and they fix the problem. And only once all the problems are fixed and all our functionalities are that are working in production are working correctly in release preview, only then most of the companies, they say, okay, we are ready for release upgrade. So every client, they make sure that they are prepared for release upgrade. I never heard about any client that doesn't prepare for release upgrade, because if a client doesn't prepare for release upgrade and they just go up, they just upgrade it, you can't stop. The client cannot say to NetSuite, hey, NetSuite, we don't want to upgrade to 16.2. That doesn't work. NetSuite doesn't accept. There are some applications which may say, okay, you don't want to upgrade, no problem, you can stay with the older version. But it's not the same with NetSuite. So NetSuite automatically, they will, in any case, they'll force upon you that you have to upgrade it on this particular date, whichever date they say. So if a client, they doesn't prepare for the upgrade and they just get upgrade it, and then they may face issues in production, like, hey, something's not working, the old functionality is not working. So that's why every client makes sure they are ready for upgrade, all the functionalities is working within upgrade. So that information is over here. You can look into it when you get your access. You can just see how it works and how NetSuite provides us the information. Then there's one more portlet here, one more KPI. You can create your own KPI. You can create your own portlets. We have all this calendar and some comparative sales. These are all the KPIs and portlets. What are KPIs? What are portlets? So KPI is a simple search, simple analysis, and portlet is something that is created from a script. Okay, that's why you may feel you're saying two things. You're saying KPIs and you're saying portlets. What are those? So KPIs are simple, which we customize, which an admin can easily customize over here. You can go to personalize and you can create a KPI. Portlet is something which is done through script. So portlet always has a script behind it. Whatever you enter in the portlet, it's even interactive. Like there may be a portlet where you enter something, there's a field, you enter data and you submit it. So there's a script behind it which takes that data and performs the functionality. And for example, if there are five fields over in a portlet, you create five fields, and sales order is only five fields. So you select those file field information. I mean, business selects the file field information, they submit it, our portlet at the back end captures this data, uses the data and creates the sales order. So that's how portlets work in the back end. So that this all we have under home. Okay, and over here we have dashboard. Actually, this is the dashboard. This is the dashboard, and then you have set preferences. So if you go to set preferences, this is not for everybody in Honeycomb who are using it. This is just for you. Like, I'm Sam David, this is just for me. These preferences are for me. So I can put a name, nickname, so I see nickname over here. I can give all my profile information, provide the email address, what all time zone I want, I can select them. These are all settings for me. You can see this, show internal IDs. I would suggest you always select this, show internal IDs. So whenever you're on a sales order, for example, you're on sales order, so let's say you're on a purchase order. So I open a purchase order, there's a field, okay? Since you will even do some development, you will even do some scripting. So when you're scripting something, for example, you may get a requirement saying, hey, on this memo field of every purchase order, we want a particular message to be set. So use a script and you set that on each and every purchase order. The script, whenever a purchase order is created, the script will open the purchase order and set that value on this memo field. So how is that set? You need the internal ID. Script always uses internal IDs of the fields. So none of the fields can be accessed by scripts using their labels. Like a script will not accept, a script will not access this field using vendor. It will always access using internal ID. So you click on the vendor, you can see over here, scroll down, this is the internal ID. Entity is the internal ID for this vendor. Okay. Click on memo, you have MEMO. This is the internal ID of memo field. You may think memo is same. It's not, every time it's not the same. So So you see invoice on hold. Let's see, customer body 11. This is the internal ID of this field. So you always need internal IDs for scripts to access these fields. So some, if for example, in on this, you don't have this show internal IDs, it's unchecked. When you come, when you click on this, you will not see the internal ID. So that's why I would suggest all the time, make sure this show internal IDs is checked. And rest all, you can look at it. So even this, whenever you practice, you have your own login, get into it, you get into set preference. Okay, there are a lot of options, a lot of settings. You might be confused, why do we have all these settings? What do this each and every setting do? No problem, just go to each and everything. So internal IDs, you can click on it, okay? And you have the help. So for every setting field, you have help. Click on the help, it says everything about it. Then you can easily understand about that field. So it's general, appearance, how do you want the theme? The color, see this, it's a default. I change it something, I say, okay, light blue. And I save it. The theme changes, see. It's a light blue theme now. So it's all your personal settings. All your personal settings you can have in setting preferences. Just go over it, everything, transactions, analytics, activities. Just go over it and just click on the field name and you'll get to know what the field does. I can't go over each and every field and show, because there are a lot of fields. It will take a couple of months in showing you guys each and every field. Even I don't know. I'll be frank. Even I don't know most of the fields. Yeah, because being a consultant, you won't get a chance to work on each and every field. These are settings. These are your settings. Nobody will ask you to set something in this. Nobody will ask you to go to set preferences and select something. It's all your settings. So if you have time, you have free time, you can get into it and play with it, or else take it easy. Whenever you are in a need, you want to set something, just look at it, look at the fee, go on the label, select it, you'll get the information on it. So that's about the home button. Then we have activities. So under activities, you have the schedules, like events, tasks. Nobody uses that this, but if you want, you can use. So events, you can set up events, you can create any event, your personal event or anything, or tasks, or phone calls, or calendar. You can, like, but most of the clients, they have Outlooks, right? So whenever you go to a client location, you're working, you have an Outlook. Most of your communication takes place in Outlook, and even your meetings, they're scheduled through Outlook. So in that case, this calendar is not required. You can go over here, you can select, okay, create an event. Okay, I need to meet so-and-so, I need to meet Sam David, and you discuss him on sales orders, regarding sales orders. So you can create all that over here. But NetSuite provides this, but nobody uses this. Activities, it's just there. NetSuite uses this. You can just go over it and see what it does, what all features are available in activities. Okay. Next, we have payments. So payments, this is taken care by, okay, I told you about two processes, right? So this order to cash process, it's taken care of by the people called AR. Okay, so AR team, in every company you will find an AR team. Okay, AR team, AR means accounts receivables. So just think about this word receivables. Receivables, nothing but you're getting something in. So since a company works on money, like they send money, they get money. So account receivables, so they are getting money from the customers. So order to cash process, the people, they're working on it. I wouldn't say the people who are creating opportunity or code or sales order. There will be marketing team, okay? What is the purpose of marketing team? They contact the customers. Hey, you want to buy some items, okay? At Honeycomb, we have these items. Do you want it? We are giving an offer. We have deals on it. That's what marketing does. And marketing might be working on code or opportunity. So AR team, it works on customer payments, like getting the payment. AR team is responsible for creating the invoices and getting the payments from customer. And there will be AP team. AP team is accounts payables. See here, the word payables itself says, okay, you're paying something. In Procure to Pay, you're paying the vendor, like HP or Dell or Office Max. You're paying him money and getting your items, like a laptop or something. So that is handled by AP team. So account payables. They take care of this vendor thing. Even the vendor, same thing. The bills and payments, that's what AP team takes care of. So there might be a requisition team, there might be a purchase team. So they take care of requisition and purchase orders. So I'm giving you an idea like how the hierarchy in company works. So I said AR and AP teams, right? So they take care of this payments thing. So you need not worry about this. But you can always get into it and see what it is. Payments overview, payment processing. So when Honeycomb has to send a payment to a customer or payment to a vendor, they come over here and they create payments, they send payments, they cut out checks. And even for sending these payments, there are some third parties. See, NetSuite doesn't do everything. So NetSuite is not going to take the money out of our account, the Honeycomb account, and send it to the customer. It's done by some other process. So I'll let you know some processes, like there's a company called Piracle Pay. There's a company called Wells Fargo. Even Wells Fargo does that. When you want to pay a customer or when you want to pay a vendor or get money from a customer, Wells Fargo does that on behalf of Honeycomb. They'll make the payment, they'll get the money, and they'll just send over the data to you, and you'll add all the data into NetSuite. But don't worry, the money is coming into Honeycomb. They're just as third party, they're just supporting tool. It's an integrated tool. We are integrating NetSuite to Wells Fargo so that Wells Fargo takes care of all of our payables and receivables. So those APAR team, they look at activities and they look at payments. Okay, then transactions. Okay, transactions, this is main, the core business, core ERP, what NetSuite does, that is under transactions. Even bank, even here you have checks, make deposits, even this is taken care of by APAR teams. And then purchasing, this is where the main business, this is the purchasing requisition team. They create requisitions with vendors, convert into POs, and then the bills, and make payments. And payables, okay, even this comes under purchasing. Over here I couldn't find bills, so that's, I was wondering. Okay, under payables you have bills. So after a PO, it converts into a bill, you create a bill, and then you make payments to vendor. You can see the pay bills. This is where you pay the vendor. You can see even vendor credits are here. Vendor returns. So there are different things. You can always look into it and you get an idea of what's happening there. And then you have sales. This is the main, where marketing, where the sales team, they work. They work with the contact, connect with the customers, and make sales, like sell the products from Honeycomb. So over here you'll see all the transactions, like opportunities, quotes, sales orders, and invoices, and all payments. Payments are under here. Under customers you'll see all the payments and what all we do with payments. So accept payments, view credit card transactions, like payments from credit card, and issue customer refund, return authorizations, receive return orders. And these are all what all we do with the money, like coming from payment from customer, and also the order. So there are different scenarios. So we clients use all this. Then we have employees. So under employees, you have Honeycomb employees. You have employee data, like over here. Even employee data you see under lists, employees. Here you can see the list of employees who all are working in Honeycomb. So these are the guys who are working in Honeycomb. And then under employees you have this enter expense reports, time tracking. But trust me, no company uses this. They have their own tools, expense report and all that. No client uses NetSuite unless they are very poor and they can't afford other applications. I guess someone left and came back in. So these are all transactions you can see. Under this, one more important thing is journals. So what is journal entry? Let's look at one journal. So each company has different accounts. You see accounts over here, lists, accounting accounts. So these are all accounts of Honeycomb. So there are many scenarios where you'll remove money from one account and put it in another account. Some may not be really accounts, but for example, company is spending on employee, okay, on all employees. So we'll have an account saying employee expenses. We create an account saying employee expenses. And on journals, what happens is money is coming out from one account and going on to other. Oh, there's nothing over here. Let's see if there's something on another journal. Oh, Honeycomb. I guess these are all practice journals. No one created a real journal. So what happens on journal is we'll select one account here. and debit is account money coming from that account. And then we have another, we'll create another account. Credit means money is going to that account. Money may really may not go, but it's just we are maintaining record. Like for example, employee expenses over here, we are paying the expenses to employee. Okay, company pays it to employee, but where to maintain the record of how much total have we paid to the employees? They create an account, and that account will be there will be a journal saying, okay, from this account, from one account we are taking out money, and from we are putting and we are setting that money into employee expenses. And one rule on journal, every time whenever you save a journal, make sure your debit and credit should always match. So debit amount should always be equal to credit amount. If it doesn't match, you cannot save a journal, you'll get an error. But don't worry, you're not going to create any journals. Business are going to create journals. So when a business, some new business user comes in, they're working on journals, they say, hey, I'm unable to save my journals. You'll say, okay, share your screen, show me how you're creating. So when they're creating, they might put $10 on debit and they might put $20 on credit. And they click on says, they say, hey, see, it's not working. Then you'll say, the thumb rule of journal is debit should always match credit. So that's how journals work. So let them know. They might be new in accounting world. So always debit should match the credit. And that's the journal process. So you're not going to create journals. They're going to create, business is going to create. We're just going to customize. So you might feel you're saying customize. What exactly is customization? You just customize nothing but they want, for example, you select currency USA. They say, okay, I selected currency Indian rupee. When I select this, exchange rate should be changed to 65. So that's the kind of customization you are making. And you say, okay, the business say, okay, we have a field value. Based upon a field value, you need to have a value set in different field. That will be a customization. And they say, okay, we want some extra fields over here. And those fields should have some different kinds of data, different values to select. That's a customization. And they say, okay, we don't want this reversal date over here. That should go in under custom tab. And that's a customization. You move this field into this tab. We'll see all that later, how we'll do all those tasks. So those all are in transactions. And then if you look at lists, we have all the employees, all the customers, all the vendors, they all are inside these lists. There are many other things which are not relevant, but you can look into it always. And if you doesn't understand anything, like for example, you come here, you see website, okay, what does this website do? What does the support do? You're unable to figure it out from the, when you click on the field, you're unable to figure out from help. Then what you do, come to help, you have a help button over here, click on help, and you have complete documentation of NetSuite, complete documentation. Like once this training is done, you forget something, you want to know, hey, what does it do, what does sales, what happens on the sales order, or what is the standard functionality in NetSuite, so you can always come to help and you can click on that, click on the search and you can get information about it. Even when you're scripting, mostly developers, they when they're beginners, they certainly they come more often to this help center. So we use, okay, I'll let you know this. Developer, when you develop a script in NetSuite, it's basic JavaScript that we use, and on top of JavaScript we just use APIs, NetSuite APIs. So let's see basic APIs. So let's see field APIs. What are field APIs in NetSuite? So you get here, go to field APIs. These are all the APIs. So you want to know what is an API, what is disabled field. Click on it, you'll get to know this explanation. There are sometimes they even have examples. You can see how you can script it. So those are all in help. So that's all under lists and reporting. So reporting, there are two things. You create save searches and you create a report. So reports are not created by us, they're created by business. So if they have an issue with reports, they'll get back to us and we need to help them fixing the issues. And then there are save searches. Save searches are like creating a report on a, like for example, the sales orders. We need to know all sales orders created last month. So you come to save searches, you create a save search, new search, you say. Then you go to transaction. You won't have sales save search record over here. Sales order record. You go to transaction. Where's transaction? Yeah, you go to transaction. You create a save search on transaction. So you want to see all the sales orders created last month. So you go to create sales search. Then you first select the type. Type is a sales order. Okay. And then your second criteria is all those that are created last month. So you will go to created date or date created, whichever one is present. Created from, okay, there's no created date. Then we look at date created. Yeah, you have date created. So date created is within, okay. So you want all last month, then okay, July 1st and July 31st. So this will give you all sales orders created from July 1st to July 31st. That is criteria, and then the results, you want all this for each and every sales order. You want all this data like date, period, tax period, type, document number, the name. On sales order, you have the customer, so customer name and all that. And when you preview, you get the results. So this is called sales search. So you're doing, you can do search on any record, any custom record or any standard record. So you got your results. So these are all sales order created last month. So Honeycomb has created 122 sales orders last month. So in under reports, you have two things. That is a search, and then you have reports. okay, let's see what are the reports created. Are there any? Okay, I'll save reports. So reports are mostly created by users. Reports. Okay, let's see. Forecast versus quota. So these are reports. Okay, these are reports. So you need not worry about this. We are not going to create anything on this. So business, they themselves work on reports. So they create the reports. Over here, they have all, they can say they select all the fields, and then they apply this on particular record. And that's how they pull out the data. And that's reporting. So only two things under reporting tab. These are all just relative. You can look at it when you have time. And then customization. So this is where we do most of our work. As a NetSuite consultant, as a NetSuite admin or NetSuite developer, we use this customization. So all our customizations over here. So we create custom lists, custom records, custom fields, and then we create custom forms over here. We create the custom PDF layouts, like on a sales order, we have a print button, we click the print button. So date on sales order comes into a PDF form. That's what we send to the customer. So we can even customize the PDF form. So that is over here, advanced PDF templates. And then scripting, this is where developers do most of their work. They create scripts, deploy the scripts. You can see all the scripts under script records. So this is all scripting and workflows. You can create workflows too. I'll let you know that when we come into developing part. Then plugins, don't worry about this. mostly no one uses plugins. It's like connecting NetSuite to some other application, but since there are more advanced techniques, like we have integration, we have like integration tools, no one nowadays uses these plugins to connect to other applications. Then we have centers, tabs, like KPI scorecards. We have even here, you can create the KPIs from here too. Suite bundler, this is this you need to know. So when you get a requirement, you create it in sandbox, you test it. You give it to business for testing, he tests it in sandbox, and then he says, okay, it's fine, now push it to production. So at that point of time, you create a bundle and you add all those you created in that requirement, in that functionality. And you create the bundle, and the bundle, you install the bundle in production. So that's when you use Suite Bundler. I'll let you know once we get into that topic, I'll make it clear to you. And that's customization. Then we have documents. Okay, let's do one thing. It's almost 7, so let's wind up today. And I'll continue the UA part from tomorrow, and hopefully we'll start getting into the admin tasks from tomorrow. Okay, guys, I'm signing off this. And if you have any questions,
it's just... 7 o'clock.
Yeah, it's 7 o'clock. Yeah. I have...
I've got a quick question to ask you.
Actually, I have a call. I have a meeting right now. So just shoot an email to me. You guys know my email ID, right? So where you got this... You must have got this from my email ID, I guess. The meeting request.
Yes,
Thank you, sir. Yeah, just send a question to it, and then I'll respond to you in reply, okay? Okay, guys. Take care, guys. See you tomorrow. Bye.
Thank you. Bye.
Welcome to Genesys Audio Conference Service. Please enter your 7-digit access code followed.